got Haas El Atrafi on. How do I say that, mate?
Yeah, that's pretty good. Good morning, everyone. Morning, Paul.
Thanks for coming on the show, mate. Mate, want to say you've got a great gym out there at Preston's. You're putting on some great shows. You put your hand up to do the Australian League titles. Where do we begin?
I will start with the league titles, if you want.
Yeah.
So, November 28th to 30th, the Australian national titles are on.
Yep.
And, of course, they're the league ones, so if anyone's confused. And, yeah, there'll be a three-day event at Club Punch Bowl. And they are open titles, so anyone from pretty much 0 fights to 1,700, whatever the experience is, it's a great opportunity for the youth. And, yeah, very excited and honoured to be part of that.
Good on you, Saturday open. So, okay, so when you say open, we're going back to the old days. So when you say a guy can end up going in the same division with one fight or fight somebody with 30 or 40 fights, that's pretty much what's going to happen, isn't it?
That's right. So
that's good. I like it.
Yeah. When coaches are nominating, we've been asking them not to send us the record.
Doesn't matter.
Yeah, we don't know anyone's record. It just makes it more interesting. So everyone's kind of on a age and weight kind of platform.
Okay, and it's going to be a Club Punch Bowl, not far from here. Now, what days are they again? The Friday, Saturday, Sunday?
No, so they'll be on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And Thursdays will be the juniors, which will be the 14 to 16-year-olds. And then the seniors will be on the Friday, and we look to have the finals and, the semis and the finals on Saturdays.
Okay, well, it's going to be huge. Now, say them dates again. The Thursday is the...
Thursday, 29th on Friday, and Saturday the 30th.
November. Well, it's going to be a big week of boxing out there at Club Punch Bowl, I can tell you.
It's exciting because before it was in Tasmania, which was a bit hard to get to, and then I think they were in Queensland before then.
Yeah.
That's not often we have them in New South Wales or Sydney, for that matter. So it's a good opportunity for... there's a lot of boxers around Sydney. It's not that far for the country boys either.
No, it's not. Well, Club Punch Bowl's pretty central to the city. And it's in a great position. But, mate, good on you. Hats off to you for putting your hand up and doing this. It's an almighty job, I can tell you that. But you've got plenty of help, haven't you, mate?
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it. It's good to have the boxing community. End of the day, I'm not doing it for myself as a promoter. I'm doing it really for the kids. And it is under the league boxing banner, which we are part of, including yourself in terms of the shows and things like that. So it is a community, and no one's making money off this.
No.
It's just trying to get the kids some fights, and it's got a opportunity for them.
Listeners out there, on them 3 days, you're going to see some of the best matchups in amateur boxing anywhere you'll see in the world. So come along the Club Punch Bowl during them 3 days, and you'll witness some great boxing. Are you going to have any family deals at all? You know, since it's a free day, let us know.
Yeah, for sure we will. We haven't worked that out, but we will be making it as affordable as possible, and we'll be doing a 3-day pass as well, which will work out very soon, and I will send that out to trainers and put on social media as well.
Okay, one thing at a time there. Okay, now tell us a bit about your gym in Preston's final round. Tell us your hours and your classes
Can I just say one thing? You guys are doing the Origin series as well, New South Wales and Queensland.
Yep, we are.
And that's a great concept, and I think that'll allow a lot of the Sydney boys and the country boys to not only fight on those shows, but then they've probably met each other back on the amateur titles as well.
Yeah, well, we're going to do a big show. We're doing I'm glad you brought it up. We're doing City vs Country on the 14th of March at Yaguna, and we're going to pick a State of Origin side out of that. And Brendan Smith up in Queensland's doing a Country vs City, and they're going to pick a Queensland Origin side out of that. We're going to do it again. And we haven't booked a date yet for the State of Origin, but it's going to be in Sydney, and it's going to be probably in July. But just letting everybody know out there, on the 14th of March is City vs Country. It was going to be at Club Punch Bowl, but it's going to be over at Yaguna. So thanks for bringing that up, mate. So we're going to, you know, but the league, Ian Batty's going to leave that weekend free so we can get as many fights as we can on that Saturday, the 14th of March. But back to your gym, mate, in Preston's final round. let the viewers out there know what classes you got. Do you want any more people, mate? I hear you're pretty busy.
I have been busy, but always welcome for people. We started off just as a little personal training center, and I remember I think we had our first fight with yourself and I don't know, was it South Junior?
Yeah, I think it was.
Years ago, and it just kind of developed through that. We didn't really promote boxing, and there was a need for our area for boxing classes, and people would constantly call, and we were running kickboxing
classes.
And they were getting pretty busy, and we were constantly getting calls for boxing, or just say, sorry, we don't. So we ran 2 days a week boxing class, and we just took capacity every time we ran those sessions. And, yeah, it just kind of evolved from there, I guess.
Just got bigger and bigger. Yeah, I see your classes are packed.
Yeah, and now we've got pretty much about 15 active amateurs and about 5 to 6 pros here. And it's kind of grown organically. We've got a good culture here.
Yeah.
We've got people of all different nationalities, and we do work with a lot of kids off the street and just people that normally would be too embarrassed to walk into a gym.
Yeah, good on you. That's great. That's great. Yeah, anybody can come in and train, mate. Anybody can come in and get fit.
You'll get people that you'll never think will put boxing gloves on, and they end up successful. As you know yourself, in history of boxing, it's not always tough guys that make it in boxing. It's just those dedicated and those that have that spark, I guess.
Yeah, those that are keen and want to go on with it. I mean, a lot of guys come to my boxer size classes and just hit the pads and what have you, and next minute they're saying, oh, I might have a fight. I said, well, you're going to get hit, you know, it's all right hitting a punch and pads until you cop one on the chin. You'll soon want to know if you want to keep doing it. A lot of them go, I'll just stick to hitting the bag and the pads. I said, yeah, you do that, that's great. But,
yeah, yeah.
You know, you don't have to jump in the ring. It still gives you self-esteem and confidence. Moving along, you've done some great promotions in the past, and you've got a cracker of a show coming up on the 9th of November at the Whitlam Leisure Centre, Liverpool. Ali Elrich and Chase Haley looks like it's a main event. And Cohen Macedonia and Luke Woods, that would have to be the main event, wouldn't it?
Yeah, so we've got...
that's a great card.
It's Cohen Macedonia. A lot of senior fighters know Cohen from the amateurs, had a really good amateur career.
He's a great amateur.
And they know Luke Woods as well, obviously, Australian rep. Both boxers are avoided boxers, to be honest, in the pros. And they both put their hand up and stepped up to crack at the IBO Oceania Orient Super Welterweight title.
It's going to be a beauty, that fight. I tried to get Luke Woods on a while back, but it didn't come off. But isn't it good? Now, here's another. Jack Brubaker's taken on Tim Zhu. We're starting to fight each other, aren't we? It's been long coming, but there's another good fight. Two good Australian fighters coming up in the ranks are going to take each other on, and we've got to see more of this. We've got to see more of it.
For sure. I think we're slowly moving away from everyone trying to protect their zero record. And whoever wins or loses out of any of these bouts, no one's going to obviously think more. I mean, boxing is very unforgiving, isn't it? You get a loss, you kind of get set back 6 months to a year sometimes with your goals.
Yeah.
But we obviously, you know, no risk, no reward. So these guys know what they've got on the line and are willing to step it up. And rather than just fight someone that's going to be a walkover from overseas, I guess.
There's no point in it, is there?
And Ali Elrich and Chase Haley, I mean...
I was going to bring that fight up. Ali Elrich, he's going places, isn't he?
Oh, and here's another one. I mean, when I was trying to match fight, before I matched him with Chase, he wouldn't even... He was kind of agreed. They were agreeing to every fight I give him. And I'm like, are you sure they're like, yeah, want to challenge ourselves?
Good.
And whoever... That fight wasn't televised, but whoever was there and saw it, it was... Like, I was just sweating watching it, and...
Yeah.
They just went back and forth 10 rounds, gave 100%. Each round you think this guy's gone, you'll come up next round. It was like a Rocky movie, to be honest.
Really?
And end of the night, no one complained that it was a draw. And they both put their hand up for a rematch. And so both of these guys know what's on the line again. And Ali Elrich was his first 10 rounder. And after the fifth round, pretty much, it was all new territory for him. And he's somewhere, I think, we had the back... Back a while, you had Nader Hamden and you know, Hussey and Nadal. And I think he's one of these kids that have kind of got a local following a lot of world's respect.
Yeah. Now I see him at hardcore occasionally. Geez, he's dedicated. He's up there with his dad, Fred.
No,
he's dedicated. All right, that was a while ago. But that's a good card moving along. Zach Cotton and Tyson Turner, that super middle. Yeah. Now, what's this for?
So Tyson Turner is from South Auckland. He's moved over here to Liverpool, and he's had three fights now with us. This will be his fourth. Zach Cotton, you know Zach Cotton. I think his brother Ryan just had one of the best KOs of the year just recently.
Good to see him have a win.
Yeah, they're just great guys, and they train so hard. And I mean, that's gonna be a cracker. That's for the Pro Box News, Pro Box Pacific Super Middleweight title.
Okay, good to see Zach getting a crack at a title.
I deserve that. Like,
he sure does.
You know, yourself, he's never said no to any fight.
No, he hasn't. Another good kid you got in your stable there making his debut, Caelan McAllister.
Yes, I'll group Caelan McAllister and Monroe. So, Caelan and Monroe making their pro debut.
Okay.
Both of them are young. Monroe's 19, Caelan's 18. Caelan's been trying by myself since he was 13 years old, made his amateur debut with us, and he lives all the way to Nola, so the kid travels 45 minutes, sometimes 60 minutes to the gym in traffic, 5-6 days a week. Since he's been a kid, his parents will bring him, and now he's a grown man, and he's never said no to any sparring, anything, no fight. He'll just take it, and he's won his last 6 fights, and I can't question his commitment.
Yeah, it sounds like he's committed. You got Danny Rio taking on Patrick Thunder, and William Mel taking on Manu.
Monroe, he's trained by Rodney Williams.
Yep.
And they call him the Matrix for a reason. Very elusive, very exciting kid to watch. And he's making his pro debut. And I think that's got a lot of excitement, a lot of buzz. And I really think he's going to be seeing quite a bit on the Australian circuit in the upcoming years.
Well, that looks like a great card, mate. For tickets, you can give yourself a call on 0423 48 000, is it? 03?
That's right, yeah.
Buy tickets on the door. That's on the 9th of November at the Whitlam Leisure Centre, Liverpool.
Yeah.
Have folks for coming on the show, mate. We'll have to cut it there.
Yep.
Mate, good luck with the Australian titles. If you need a hand, just give us a holler.
Yep, will do.
And never say you're too busy for business, mate. Basil Nazel nearly said it before, but you can never get enough business, can you?
No.
Thanks for coming on the show, mate.
Thanks for having me, Paul. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Mr. Hass El Chafrafi.
No, thank you, Paul. Enjoy your day.
Thanks, buddy. Bye, mate.
Thanks.
And there's another fine guy doing good things for Australian boxing. We're promoting. We're going to go to a break.